Good. Hey, here's Mike Mackay. He's back to see us again with the bionic wrists. And once again, another gorgeous piece of work here. You're, boy, we're getting into the motor vehicles, aren't we? This is like the third one in a row.
Yeah, this is a little red fire truck. Again, when I sculpt, I like to sculpt humor. I like a lot of action on everything. These guys, you can see them driving along. The one guy's got his eyes covered because you really don't like the way this guy's driving. Another guy's pointing where to turn. Dog's howling away up on top. This guy's over here is blowing a horn. Yeah, little ceramic ladders.
Now,
it's all ceramic, the whole thing. It's all sculpted out of clay, just like we use
on here. So the ladder is clay too?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Clay and then just fired into ceramic. And this is one all the national competition also. This is another national winner. And most of the time when I sculpt, like I say, I sculpt humor and it's very hard to win. And for some reason they never judge humor art as being very realistic.
As long as we're doing that, you've got the guy on the back, uh-huh. And he is
trying to catch up.
Trying to catch up the fire hose that is going around, and this fire hose is around his foot. Yeah. Can we see that?
That guy, see, don't even have his shorts on. He's only got his shorts on because he's in such a hurry to get there.
And it's going all the way clear up here to where
the dog is howling.
Dog.
And these cars that we're getting into that we're going to build, the secret on doing things like this is pretend you're building a wooden box. Mm-hmm. Basically, you're slabbing out clay half an inch thick. And not next week because we're not on, but the week after that, I'll show you how to go into these cars.
Good for you.
See, I remember
great
some things,
memory
you know?
And everything. And so you do the basic box, and then you put these pieces on with that glue that you've showed us over and over again, and then you have to go get the thing fired so that it'll stay together.
Mm-hmm. See, what I do for the most part is I take my clay and I roll it out with a rolling pin, and like I say, the kids, if you get into kids or even adults, they can steal their wife's rolling pin. But you see, I start with just a square block like this, see?
So you got parts.
Yeah, and it's just like a kit. And you just more or less draw yourself a car that you want and then pretend it's a box. And by taking this clay and putting it together, you can take old toothpicks, you know, and basically put the sides in and stick a toothpick through it and then just kind of shape it. But this, as you see, you look at the side of it, it's just a box with a notch, and then the front fenders are just long roll of clay and then lift it up.
Oh yeah, the box part is simple. You make the sound, I get a kick out of it. You make the sound so simple. That's not the hard part of this. Mm-hmm. Anybody can make a fire engine. How do we do these little guys with their hand? That's where the real artistry comes in, and probably a lot of experience doing it too, I imagine, huh?
Well, the little guys, again, when I sculpt, you see, if I sculpt something and I feel like I don't have enough pizzazz to it, by adding humor to it, I can get a lot of action. You know, as people be looking at this or looking at the guy running, the dog howling, instead of just a truck sitting there, it's doing something, you know. Mm-hmm. To me, that's the way art should be. I don't like things that don't do something, you know. And you go into a lot of art galleries or things and you'll see some really pretty cars and stuff sculpted in ceramic and things.
Just sitting.
Yeah, and it's, like I say, the hard part about this one, the reason it was one of the high winners, is red in a glaze is the hardest color to get a uniform color of, is red. And if you look at the gold around the grill and everything, golds and silvers, all of these plates, if you put this material on too thick, it powders up and it goes into dust. So your chances of doing something like this and getting all the colors to fire
are just about nil.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for the encouragement, Mike. One more thing before you take that off of there. How it looks to me like it's affixed to this board. What is that, glue or epoxy or what?
No, what happened was, I hate to keep accidents I have with my artwork on the freeways.
Another one of those bad days.
Yeah. This one, it was pretty much the same thing. I was afraid that the wheels wouldn't support the weight of this. And if that would break and it fell, it would break a fender or something. So what I did, I took boat resin and I put on a piece of wood. Mm-hmm. And then I set the thing on there so that the wheels couldn't tilt or move in any way. Because this is a lot of weight for just glass wheels, you know. And by doing this, these wheels can't go, you know.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So it was, like I say, the only reason that happened was is I, just from moving it and stuff, I could tell that the wheels were never going to hold that support.
Okay, I just was curious. I couldn't figure out how. Yeah, I think when you pick this up, I expect it to roll right off the end of the board.
Oh, yeah, I hope not. But this is something I'm doing for the Mojave Living Desert.